press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to the classroom. We have been discussing about the chapter Electricity and Circuits. See, in the previous class, we learned about the electricity. Electricity is it is energy. It is a one form of energy which can be transmittable and also can be controllable. See, this is the type of energy. It is one of the form of energy. Electricity is produced in the power station. See, as I told you in the previous class, electricity which is produced in the power station. See, in the power station, when the heavy flow of water will be takes place, as that they will fix a turbine at the beneath the sea or the lake, they will fix the turbine so that when the water will be flows through the high power and it will rotates this turbine, thereby power will be generated, that is electricity will be produced. And so that's why electricity can be produced in the power station, and there afterwards it will reaches to our homes, offices, schools, shops, etc. reaches to homes, school, offices, etc. See, through the wires as well as the cable. See, electricity, it is a form of energy which can be transportable. It will transfer from one place to another place and can be controllable. Either we have to switch on or switch off. It can be controllable. By putting switch off, the electricity will be cut off. And thereby we can say that it is a transportable as well as the controllable. And this electricity will be produced in the power station and thereby reaches to our home, office, shops and different places. And through the wires as well as the cables, it will transported. And this is the definition or the definition as well as the how this electricity will be produced. And there are different gadgets will be there and different devices will be there where we can see the flow of electricity, like a torch, tube light, bulb, etc. These are some electric gadgets and devices which helps us to identify the flow of electricity in such a devices. And in today's class, we will learn about the electric bulb. See, electric bulb is a device which can be converted into the electrical energy, into the heat as well as the light energy. See, it is electric bulb is a device which converts the electrical energy or the electrical energy into heat and light energy. See, what is the meaning of electric bulb? See, electric bulb is a type of a device where it will convert the electric energy. Electric energy is converted into the heat as well as the light energy. See, when we switch on the electric bulb, then it will glow and thereby it will also convert it into the heat energy. See, after switch of the bulb, if you touch the bulb, then you can see then you can feel that the heat will be generated in the bulb. See, we can say that electric bulb is nothing but a device which can convert the electric energy into the heat as well as the light energy. See, this is the definition of the electric bulb. And next we shall move on to the structure of the electric bulb. See, electric bulb is made up of a glass base. Electric bulb is made up of a glass case and also fixed at a metallic boss, which is fixed at a metallic base. See, electric bulb is made up of, this is the structure of the electric bulb, where we can say that electric bulb is made up of a glass case. The outer surface of the bulb is made up of a glass case, and where at the base it is fixed with a metallic base. See, at the base the metal will be present so that it will hold the glass container or the glass base, and here the two terminals will be present. And this glass base containing the two terminals, that is positive as well as the negative terminals. And here filament will be there, and above inside the bulb there is a filament will be there. And usually the filament is made up of a tungsten. Tungsten is nothing but a metal which conducts or conducts the flow of electricity. So that's why the filament is made up of a tungsten. And the two terminals are present here, and this is the structure of the electric bulb. See, as I told you, the bulb is made up of a glass case which is fixed at the base. A metallic base will be present, and here the coiled structure will be present. It is nothing but the filament, which is made up of a tungsten, and here two wires will be located, and these two wires will be thick, and two wires which are thick in nature, out of these two wires, that is, as I written, the green as well as the purple wire, I will written here so that you can easily identify which wire I am talking about. See, this filament is situated the two wires, and these two wires is the thick. Out of these two wires, one wire is connected with the base of the metal. See, metal base, one wire is fixed, and usually this metal, the wire is fixed at the base of the metal, and at the center it is situated. Base of metal, one wire is fixed or situated at the base of the metal. See, here the green wire is situated at the base of the metal, and another wire is fixed to the top of the metal. Another wire is fixed to the top of metal case. See, this is, we call it as a metal case, and here two portions will be there. One is the metal tip and another one is the metal base. These two wires, what I am telling about, this first wire is situated and at the center, whereas the another wire, which is situated at the tip of top of the metal base. And see, usually the metal tip connected to the metal base, and forms the two terminals of the bulb. See, these two wires will forms the two terminals here. One is the positive terminal and another one is the negative terminal. Two terminal already written here, and these two terminals are positive terminal. That is, I indicated that positive sign, one terminal is the positive terminal and another one is the negative terminal. Always negative is indicated with the symbol minus C. See here, this is the structure of the electric bulb. Once again, I will tell you, the electric bulb is a device which converts the electrical energy into the light as well as the heat energy. See, when you switch off the electric bulb, if you touch the bulb after some times, you can see the heat generated in the bulb. So we can say that electric bulb is a device which converts the light energy as well as the heat energy. And the structure of the electric bulb, see, the base of the electric bulb having the metal base, and outside the metal base there is a glass base will be present, so that inside the these bulb is many more parts will be there, and the coil structure is called as filament, and this filament is usually made up of a tungsten, so that when we switch on the bulb will glow, and this filament will be heated up, and thereby the bulb will be glow. See, during the electricity flows, this filament will be heated up, and thereby the bulb will glow. During the flow of the electricity, this filament will be heated up, and thereby it will glow. And this filament is situated, the two wires will be connected, and these two wires, out of these two wires, one wire is connected at the base of the electric bulb. See here, and situated usually at the center of this bulb, and another one wire is situated at the top of the electric bulb, see, top of the metallic bulb, and see, these two wires, which are usually thick in nature, and one is situated at the base of the metal base, and another one is the top of the metal case. See, this is the structure of the electric bulb, and these electric bulb having the two terminals, one is the positive terminal and another one is the negative terminal, and they were fixed in such a way that they will not mix or the touch each other. See, like that they were fixed. See, this is the structure of the electric bulb. Next one is the how it will glow, we will learn. See, when the electricity passes, through the one terminal, it will flows to the filament, and thereby, after flowing, the electricity flows into the filament, thereby passes out to the other terminal. And when the electricity flows through the tungsten, that is the filament, it gets heated up and glow. So this is how the electricity will be produced in the electric bulb. See, as I told you, the structure of the electric bulb having the two terminals, positive terminals as well as the negative terminals, which is situated at the center of the, one terminal is situated at the center of the metal base, and another terminal, that is the negative terminal, will be situated at the top of the metal case. And here tungsten, a type of a metal which is acts like a filament, and usually the filament is made up of a tungsten. And here thick wire, this is called the two wires, two terminals will be present, and this is the thick wire, it is present. And usually when the electricity flows through the electric bulb, the filament will be heated up and later the bulb will be glow. And see when the electricity flows through the, passes through the one terminal, see, observe this table, and now you compare this one. See, when the electricity will be produced or flows, passes from one terminal, consider if the electricity will passes from one terminal here and later it will move on to the, it is passes through the filament, and thereby it is passes out to the another terminal, and thereby we can say that the bulb will be glow. And during this process, when filament get heated up, and thereby the electricity will be produced in this bulb, and later the bulb will be glow. See, this is how the electricity produced in the bulb. See, once again I will tell you, as I told you, the structure of the electric bulb. And see how the electricity will be produced in the bulb, we will learn. See, consider when the electricity is passes from the one terminal, and thereby it will passes through the terminal, one terminal, and thereby it is flows to the filament. And this filament is usually made up of a tungsten. And here again the electricity will be passes out to the another terminal, and when this process will happening, the electricity will be passes through the filament, and this filament get heated up, and thereby electricity will be produced, and bulb will be glow. And this is how the electricity will be produced in the bulb. See here we will learn about the how the electricity will be produced in the electric bulb, and also we learned about the what is the meaning of electric bulb. Electric bulb is nothing but a device which can be converted into the electrical energy into light energy as well as the heat energy. See, if we touch the bulb, after switched off the bulb, then we can say that it is a hot in nature. See, don't try to touch the bulb during the hot condition or the bulb when the bulb is glow. See, it is very dangerous for touching the bulb. It is very heated up. So that's why after leaving some gap, and thereby if you touch the bulb, you can feel the hotness of the bulb. And see, we can say that electric bulb can be used to convert the electrical energy as well as the electrical energy into the light energy as well as the heat energy. See, when the electricity will be produced and it will passes through the one filament, one terminal, and thereby the filament will be heated up when the process will be start, and thereby it is passes to the another terminal. So that's why when the bulb will be glowing, the process will be takes place. That is, the electricity will be passes from the one terminal and it flows to the filament. Filament flows to the filament, and then again it will pass out to the another filament, another terminal. And during the process of electricity which flows in the bulb, and the filament get heated up, and thereby the bulb will be glow. See, this is how we can say that when the bulb is when the electricity will flows into the bulb will be heated up, and later the glowing of the bulb will be takes place. This is all about the electric bulb. Next we shall move on to the another concept. See, next we shall move on to the danger sign. See, this symbol you have, you might have seen this type of symbol in the various places like electric poles, cables and the electric places, power station. See, this danger symbol, that is this one, you might have seen in the electric poles. Electric poles, power station, cables, which is having the high voltage of electricity, high voltage of electricity, high voltage of the electricity. See, next concept is the dangerous sign. See, you might have seen the different places which is having this displayed this type of a sign, and usually this type of a sign, that is a dangerous sign, is displayed on the electric poles, cables and the power station, and this symbol is represent to caution the people to stay away from the places where there is a high voltage of electricity will be flow in such a places. See, even kill the person when the electricity is flow in a very much quantity and thereby kill the many peoples. So that's why a danger sign will be symbolized to caution the people to stay away from the high voltage electricity in such a area. See, this is the another concept, and it is very important whenever this symbol you have seen, you stay away from the place, and thereby if you want to go means you take the permission from the elders and such a electrician to move, and thereby the symbol is represent to stay away, to be caution for the people to stay away from such a places where the electricity will be flow in a high voltage. Usually in the electric cell having the 1.5 volts, whereas these kinds of places having high voltage of the electricity. So that's why the people or the electrician will be display this type of symbol in such a places like power station, electric poles and the cables, and which is having the high voltage, to caution the people to stay away from the these places which is having the high amount of electricity. And this is all about the today's class. Next we shall move on to the another one, that is electric cell. See, electric cell is nothing but a device which can be converted into the heat energy, a device which can be converted into the light energy, chemical energy into the electrical energy is called as electric cell. See, this is the brief introduction about the electric cell. Today's class, this much only. And next class we will learn some more concept which is related to the chapter. Here I wind up the class. Thank you.